can see, I've got the board out again, bit of a hole I want to fill in there. Now usually when you mix filler, you mix it on a board, and sometimes you may want to mix it in a tray or a bowl, but a lot better to mix it on a board. A couple of reasons. One, instantly I can go off and start filling, especially low down. And two, not too much waste. So let's get the filler mixed up and then we can get it in there. Before mixing any filler, it's important to eliminate any dust, especially on plasterboard or hard wall plaster, any cracks, any holes. So taking the lid, some water and a pot, roughly 8 caps of water, taking your PVA, 1 cap of PVA, just clean that out. Give it a thorough mix. Set this to one side. Now I can mix some filler. I've got a few knives here, a couple of filling blades. Good angle knife there, and just a scraper, which I do like to use for mixing. So, powder filler, it really is quite easy doing this. Scraper, create a small well. Bring those edges in. Okay. Now just start to add the water. Just allowing the filler to fall in. Add some from around the edges. Water. Already the powder taking up the moisture, taking up the water. Touch more water. Bit more drying from the wrong side. More water. Okay. Bring in the dry in. Remaining dry stuff. Let's tuck the water so I can start to knock it together a little bit. Still thick. Constantly cleaning the board round as you go in. Okay, now I can go for the other blade. Can afford a touch more there. Trick is not to have it too thin. So that's now a nice creamy consistency. Okay. That's good. Want it drooping too much. Good. I just want to take some of this filler and put it in here. Yeah. Wet filler there. And I'll just cover it in water. That's underwater there. Leave that in. The inside of here will be quite dusty. So, brush, PVA, just rub around that edge. Any drips like this will dry quite hard, so just wipe those away. with this small knife inside. Just draw it back. Now for a knife that's been blade that's been cleaned up a bit, damp cloth, about 30 minutes. Oh, just touched it. So, damp cloth again. I'm just going to go back over this time. It's still too wet. Okay, again, carefully just wipe around the edge. Leave it 30 minutes. Is up. I've mixed up a small amount there, a little bit thinner than it was last time, but still holds itself. First one, always a little bit thicker, a little bit heavier, less sag. This is the bit that I put in the water before.
And as you can see, it's a little bit crumbly on the edge. 30 minutes. So it always wants to dry this stuff. So leave it there, and that'll fully cure, fully dry out. Going to use this small blade again with the damp rag. Just wipe this blade. I just want to check over this. Just make sure there's no sag. A little bit just come off there. Again, this has only been about 30 minutes. Okay, no problem. It's a multi-purpose filler this, so you can fill wood and plaster, brickwork, plasterboard, no problem. Bit of diluted PVA. Remember to push it in, get some in, push it in there. And pretty much the same. To go off, sand it, fill it, prime it, and paint it. If you're using oil paint on this, leave it to fully dry out. If you're doing repairs on walls or something like this and using a water-based paint, then this doesn't necessarily have to be fully dry. So if you were using paint that was microporous. And remember, you can always save a little bit of sanding by carefully just coming up to that edge and cleaning off as much as you can. Really is quite strong when it dries, and you can drill into it. So somewhere here, there's been a repair, which I did. Just take a look at the reverse of the board. You can see there's been many repairs. So this one I've already drilled into. This one I haven't yet. And that's what I've just done. But I'm going to drill into this one. Actually, it's somewhere there, not there. Here, so I'll find exactly where it is and we'll drill into it. So I got straight in the center-ish, not too bad, but that's okay. I'm drilling into this board. If you were going into a wall where you'd done a repair, then that'd be fine. If you hit the patch of filler that you'd previously filled or somebody else had. But like I say, when you look at the repairs that have been done, that's what I've just done there, that one there. That one was drilled through in the past. And yeah, that's what I've just done. So the one that I painted really quick that one down there. Something like that. You would probably leave longer to dry, but that was just to show that it can be done, as with all of these. So again, if you're wanting to put a plug after drilling, no problem there. Just one's knocking in a bit. But yeah, sound repair, no worries there.